Good morning, this is Jyoti Mai, Department of Biology. So here, today we are going to discuss about the last portion of the large intestine, the digestion and nutrition in animals. So now we are going to know about the nutrition and ruminants. What are the ruminants? Do you know the grass-eating animals are known ruminants? Why they are known ruminants? What's the reason? That we look at now. Okay, so now look at it. Generally, this is, I hope I'm expecting that. I drew a cow digestive system and I'm hoping that you could be able to understand it. Not thinking that it's a buffalo or something else. Okay, this is. So, ruminants. Who are the ruminants here? So, what are the ruminants? So, this is cow, buffalo, sheep, goat, camel, horse. These all are generally known ruminants. Why they are known ruminants? Generally, in our 6th class, you learned about it. The organisms, they take some food into their body and through the mouth, they swallow it. But they store a side of their stomach and they bring back the food to their mouth. Again, they reach away and they send the food into stomach again. This process called rumination. The organisms who can bring back their food from stomach to mouth and can reach out properly and can send it to inside, then that process is called rumination. The organisms who can follow the rumination called ruminants. So now, today, we are going to discuss about ruminants and in them, what is the digestive system, how rumination takes place. Okay, just now look at it. So this is cow. So in cow, there are different parts present in its digestive system like this. So this is the first part, what we are finding here is mouth. And you know the mouth automatically is connected to food pipe. Food pipe is also known esophagus. Am I right? Esophagus. And this esophagus connected to a large chamber present in it. The stomach has four parts. The first part is called reticulum, which is present here. And the second part is called rumen. It's completely occupied. Okay. And rumen after the third part present omasum. Omasum after the last part present in the stomach is called ebomasum. Omasum, last part chamber, ebomasum. Okay. And this stomach is connected to a tube, small intestine. And this small intestine is connected with the large intestine. Got it? And here this is a part also, connection for this large intestine. So this is about the digestive system of cow. So just you can imagine the same system also can be found in other animals. So now, so generally, in our ruminants, they take green color plants. They eat green color substance. Whether they are grass, plants, leaves, anything which are in green color. Got it? And the green color grass, when they eat it very hurry-burry. Because they want the food at first. Because they won't wait for anyone. If they wait for some other animal, maybe come and they eat it, right? So that they immediately they take the food. They grab the food fast without chewing. Okay, so how it goes? So that I'll show you now. So I'll draw this food pipe little broader. Then you can easily understand how the food pathway is taking place through it. Okay, so think this is food pipe. In this food pipe, suppose when it is eating food from the mouth, from here, it's eating food, okay? From the mouth, when it is eating food, taking grass or leaves, the food directly where the food comes out stores, which food undigested and not chewed food comes out deposits here. After completion of the having food, then they go and sit under the trees and leisure. When they are leisure, they when they are sitting under the tree, when they are leisure, they bring back the food from room air. So the food again will come back to storage room. From here it goes. And again from there onwards, it come back to a part, the second part of the first part of the stomach called reticulum. What is the second part? Reticulum. And there it comes and decomplete it into small pieces. And from there onwards, again it goes back to the mouth. And it starts chewing. It starts chewing. And after complete chewing, again the food comes back. But the food which comes back doesn't go to the rumen or to the reticulum. It directly goes to the first part of the stomach called omasum. Or is a part called omasum. I hope you people may be unable to understand it properly. Again, one more time I'll clearly explain you. Just look at here. Okay? So now look. So generally when a cow takes food, it goes from mouth to rumen and deposits it. After deposition, the food again comes back. Food again comes back to the place where reticulum goes in. And to the area reticulum it comes. When it comes to reticulum, it becomes into small piece. From there onwards, again the food goes into the mouth. It rechews. After rechewing, the food comes back to the third chamber called omasum. Later, here, the food becomes partially digested. Later, it goes from omasum to ebomasum. From again ebomasum, the food comes back and goes to the small intestine. And here, the food is absorbed. Waste material goes from large intestine to outside. This is about rumination. Got it? Again, one more time, I'll repeat it. There are different parts present. The first part called mouth. Second part called esophagus is also a food pipe. And third part is stomach. It's very big. Has four parts in it. The first part called reticulum. Second part rumen. It's a very big chamber. And third part is called omasum. Fourth part ebomasum. Later, the small intestine goes in and it is connected with the large intestine. The food which is taken by an animal, of a cow, buffalo, anything, green material, goes from mouth to directly into rumen. And later, it partially, slightly digested. When it comes back to the reticulum, it's slightly digested. That material is called actually curd. C-U-D, curd. And the curd comes back to the mouth again and it chews properly. The process of bringing back the curd to mouth and rechewing process is called rumination. By this process, after completely chewing, the food again sent back to the, this is 1, 2, 3, and 4, goes to the third chamber. Later there it partially digested. From there onwards it goes to the ebomasum, the completely digested. From there onwards it goes to the small intestine. Food is absorbed. Later the waste material comes out from the large intestine. By this way, the digestive system works. Is it clear? So next we will learn and we will look at about the next one. Once again I will repeat the digestion part of amoeba, hydra, cilia, and paramecium. Okay, once again I'll repeat it for you. Just look at here. I'm going to write this. So students, please note it down, this diagram, and practice. And in your textbook the parts are not allotted properly. Note it down, these parts. okay, and read the textbook. In textbook they gave bathroom rumination and room names, but they didn't mention about these parts and explanation. Okay, so this is next. I'm going to explain you about amoeba, paramecium, and hydra. You've seen like some microscopic organisms, how they follow digestion, unicellular organisms, the organisms which are made up of single cell. The organisms which are made up of single cell. So we now look at about those organisms. Just look at. So the first one, I'm taking amoeba. How they digest? In starting class, we discussed about it. So amoeba is which is in non-shape, which doesn't have a proper shape due to the presence of pseudopodia in it, the finger-like projections. They help for capturing the food. Then how they help in a capturing the food? Now you can. Just for example, here is a food. This pseudopodia. Now here I am taking. Here is a food. Then these pseudopodia expands and traps food. And then wrapper food. Where the wrapper food present, that area is called food vacuole. What is it? Area is called food vacuole. Vacuole means the empty space where the food is present. And here, the food is being digested into pieces because it releases some enzymes to out. And later when it is released into enzymes to out, here the digestion takes place and food becomes into simpler form and diluted form. These diluted food again taken by amoeba. This is a process called pinocytosis or phagocytosis. Pina means when it's taking a food in the form of liquid, because it's a unicellular organism. It doesn't have any digestive system separately. So it digests the food into food vacuole and it absorbs the food again. After the absorption of food, again the pseudopodia comes into a normal position. Again, changes its shape normal. Again, when it gets any food, again it expands. Any area, any finger can be helpful. And this finger is also helpful for movement. And by this way, they take liquid at any food into the body. Pina, liquid. Cytosis. Pina means liquid, whether it is maybe water. Cyton means cell. Cytos. Cell. So in cell, the food is taken through the cell membrane. This is the part of cell membrane, right? Pseudopodia only. But the cell membrane is modified as a pseudopodia. This pseudopodia helps in absorption, whether it is liquid form, phago means solid form. Okay, this process is called pinocytosis of phago. The same procedure is followed by another organism here, that is euglena. So I'll tell you about the euglena. So this is euglena. This is also an aquatic animal. So where it is present in water. Got it? Where it is present? In water it is present. So here it actually has a chloroplast to make its own food. But here also it has a vacuole. So this is a part is called mouth. So with the help of, this is called flagella. It's known flagella actually. It's a tail like structure which traps the food and it sends a food to mouth. From mouth it goes into inside and here a food vacuole is formed again. Here also. What is formed here also? Food vacuole is formed and it will be digested inside and utilized. Understood? And by this way it follows the digestion. Then what about the paramecium? We also have to look about the paramecium. Paramecium is also an aquatic organism which follows the digestion. You know, it also known slipper on the molecule. It's appearing slipper shape. And it only the cell, here the organism has two nucleus in it. And it also has contractile vacuole. hairy like structures called cilia. The hairy like structure. This cilia traps the food and sends the food to mouth. When it's sent to the mouth, mouth is open. The food enters inside. When the food is entered inside, here it forms a pseudoalveoli. What it forms? Pseudoalveoli. And when food is entered into here, the enzymes are secreted and it digests the food and utilizes for the whole body. So by this way, there are different organisms which they follow for digestion. Understand? Which they follow? Digestion. So generally, in a human being, the digestive system is present, containing of alimentary canola and digestive glands. And next, the rumination and a ruminants. The process of rumination also takes place in digestive system, which contains the four chambers of stomach, esophagus, and small intestine and large intestine. Even in single cell organisms also the food is digested. And how these digested food is utilized by our body? You know, by the process of assimilation. After assimilation, what happens? Happens respiration. By the process of respiration, the energy is produced. What will happen to that energy? How the energy is produced? How it is utilized by our body? Everything we will look at in the next further class. So I hope in this class you understood everything about the digestive system. Got it. So I'll give the links of YouTube. So just follow that links. And today onwards, you will get your classes in announcement. So even tomorrow also. I mean, when you have your classes, then you get in your YouTube link. Just follow that and read textbook majorly. Read your textbook completely from starting to ending. Understand? So I'm giving the time to you today and tomorrow. And the day after tomorrow means on Wednesday. Wednesday you have a small ST regarding this lesson. Is it clear? And I'll send you quizzes from the quizzes.com. A quiz I'll send you from this lesson. Do that quizzes by tomorrow. I'll send it. Do that. And day after tomorrow you have the examination regarding this lesson. So thank you children. Have a nice day. Enjoy.